Good morning, good afternoon and good evening to all Dinarians on the go and in the know. Like, subscribe, and share with your fellow Dinarian friends. To help support our channel, we now accept tips via the Brave browser and BAT tokens. It makes a huge difference and is very much appreciated. To those of you that made a contribution, I thank you. If you have not already done so, pick up your free trial copy of the newly enhanced currency exchange planner in the description of this video, voted the number one pre and post RV planning tool for the dinar community. Created by a dinarian, for dinarians, to ensure your exchange goes smoothly and for mapping out all your future financial goals and assets, including the Iraqi dinar, Vietnamese dong, Iranian rial and of course gold and silver, my favorites. When you decide you want to unleash the full power of the planner, use the promo code, thedinarian, and get 25% off along with the newly upgraded version 8 mobile application added free for my subscribers for a limited time. A preview of both the mobile application and the desktop planner is made available on the website for your convenience. I assure you, once you see the planner in action, you will know why it is the number one planner in Dinarland. Lock in your copy, the link is in the description. I am also recommending that you register as an affiliate with the Carat Bar Gold Savings Program, the gold program designed to save gold in your choice from a gram up to any amount you would like. They place each fully certified gram of gold on a credit card style placard for easy storage and send it directly to your door via FedEx. It makes saving physical gold easy and affordable for everyone, 1 gram at a time. Are you prepared if the coronavirus takes out the markets and the world economy collapses? Is your savings protected in a tangible asset like gold? It is free to register and get yourself all set up for both pre and post exchange gold saving. Both the links to these invaluable programs are in the description box below. Always remember, knowledge is power. Using that knowledge is powerful. Before we get started today, I would like you to pay close attention to this first article, especially as I have been waiting for this one. We should be seeing more and more articles like this one coming out now. This is why I have been posting and trying to educate you on CBDCs the past few months. Get used to it, as we are heading away from the fiat system at a rapid pace now. And now, so is our beloved IRAQ. But don't worry, fiat and digital will coexist for a period of time, in my opinion of course, but what do I know? First article of interest for today. Jordan displays its experience in the field of digital economy to IRAQ. The Iraqi Ministry of Foreign Affairs confirmed, on Tuesday, that Jordan presented its experience in the field of digital economy to IRAQ. A statement by the ministry stated that the Iraqi ambassador to Amman Haider al-Athari met the Jordanian Minister of Digital Economy and Entrepreneurship Mathana Gharibe and discussed ways to enhance cooperation and coordination between the two countries. The statement quoted al-Athari asserting that Iraq is currently moving towards the use of technology in various fields, especially banking services, noting that strengthening the economic partnership between the two countries would serve the common interests of the two friendly peoples. For his part, according to the statement, Gharib welcomed any effort contributes to the transfer of Jordanian expertise in the digital economy and leadership to Iraqi ministries and institutions. Next article of interest. America sets a new rule to impose fees on countries that devalue their currencies. The U.S. Department of Commerce is putting the finishing touches to a new rule to impose anti-subsidy duties on products from countries that the department sees as depreciating its currencies against the dollar, including likely China. The move, taken by Washington on Monday, could be a new nuisance in trade talks between the United States and China just weeks after the world's two largest economies signed a one-stage trade agreement between them and one day after Beijing accused Washington of spreading fear of the rapidly spreading coronavirus that he grew up in China. In theory, the new rule would allow the Commerce Department to impose duties on China, although the U.S. Treasury recently deleted its classification of China as a currency manipulator under the one-stage commercial agreement. The Commerce Department said the rule would not apply such duties to all imports from a particular country as it does not all harm U.S. industries. The administration of President Donald Trump is doing the right thing by confronting the problem directly, the ministry said in a statement. Trade Minister Wilbur Ross said the new rule represents another important step aimed at creating space for American companies and workers. In addition to China, the new base may put other countries' products at risk of increasing tariffs, including Germany, Ireland, Italy, Japan, Malaysia, Singapore, South Korea, Vietnam, and Switzerland. Next article of interest: the future of money. The problem with all currencies is that their values are unstable. The stable coin addresses this by spreading assets over the top currencies in the world in gold. Image: Chris Ratcliffe, Bloomberg. It lies in the cryptosphere, and what's coming should terrify national governments. Every generation or so, money goes through an evolutionary shift, and 10 years from now the fiat currencies currently in use will be regarded as relics of a bygone age, much like the fax machine. Cryptocurrencies backed by artificial intelligence, AI, are about to swarm the world of money, bringing with them a level of stability that central banks promised and never delivered. About to come is a whole new architecture for the world financial system, including investment. In the world of investing, the days of the brilliant stock picker may be numbered. AI and predictive technology will swallow them whole. New cryptocurrencies promise everything a unit of money should offer in a technological age: a globally accepted unit of value, instant transfer, anonymity, and security. All currencies suffer one critical deficiency: their values are unstable. That's largely a function of central bank control over the issue of new money and the resulting inflation, which eats at currency values. This complicates the world of commerce, since all trade rests upon a floating barge of variable currency value. South Africans understand what this means. The rand is the world's most traded emerging market currency. Back in the 1970s, a US dollar cost 70 cents in the rand. Today, one US dollar costs our 14.60, which is nearly 21 times more expensive than 50 years ago. This might be an extreme case, but all currencies in a free-floating system suffer the same problem. Bitcoin attempted to change all this by removing money issue from the control of any central banks. There will never be more than 21 million bitcoins in issue. Since its launch in 2009, Bitcoin has gone from nothing to more than $12,000, making it the world's best performing currency in the last decade. The cryptoniverse has been defined by Bitcoin and a few lesser coins, powered by speculative interest and wild swings in value. None so fast as a credit card. But as a payment system, none have been able to replicate the speed and convenience of a Visa card system, with payment executed in seconds. That will change as technology and transaction speeds improve. Lars Holst, founder of London-based crypto exchange GCEX, has studied the future of money for years and believes Africa is ripe for a crypto-monetary revolution. I don't think we're far away from replicating Visa and MasterCard payment systems in terms of speed. The whole settlement system in Forex is inefficient, says Holst, who previously worked in Forex at Danish-based Saxo Bank. Why should it take 2 days to settle Forex payments? And the fees you were charged for this are excessive. The fiat money system has been corrupted by central banks printing excessive amounts of money and debasing the currencies. Many of the new cryptocurrencies coming to the world take this power out of the hands of central banks. It's clear that the future is in crypto rather than fiat currencies. Bitcoin founder Satoshi Nakamoto and others have applied themselves to the question of a future money system using blockchain technology to verify and validate payments between two people transacting anywhere in the world. In 2009, Satoshi explained the problem with the current fiat money system that inspired Bitcoin. The root problem with conventional currency is all the trust that's required to make it work. The central bank must be trusted not to debase the currency, but the history of fiat currencies is full of breaches of that trust. Banks must be trusted to hold our money and transfer it electronically, but they lend it out in waves of credit bubbles with barely a fraction in reserve. We have to trust them with our privacy, trust them not to let identity thieves drain our accounts. Identity will be central to the future of money. The current monetary system Satoshi complains about is a relatively modern confection. As David Birch points out in his book Identity is the New Money, we entered the world of fiat currency when Richard Nixon ended the convertibility of the US dollar into gold in 1971. As such, fiat is relatively new. The next evolution is now about to sweep it aside. Just as the machine-made, uniform, mechanized coinage introduced by Isaac Newton in 1696 better matched the commerce of the Industrial Revolution, so we can expect some form of digital money will better match the commerce of the information age, writes Birch. Holst argues that fiat currencies, if they exist in 10 years, will have a small portion of the market. We're in the era of not just data, but information. We upload information to blockchain in an encrypted form so it is not seen by other people. By 2030, we'll see more private use of what people decide to do with their value. They will have simple keys to keep this information private in a global public network where it is logged but cannot be changed. What is about to be let loose on the world should terrify national governments and central banks. Who in Zimbabwe or Venezuela would not ditch their corrupted currencies for something that is stable, internationally recognized, and beyond the reach of their governments? The impact of cryptocurrencies on developing countries will likely be huge. Vodacom and Safaricom launched the M-Pesa mobile money service in Kenya and Tanzania in 2007, allowing users to deposit money into an account stored on their cell phones and transfer funds using PIN-secured SIMs to other users and redeem cash instantly. Millions of previously unbanked people now have a payment system that bypasses the banks and is being studied around the world. It's a relatively small step from this to the cryptosphere and monetary independence. There is plenty of talk about money moving into the digital age, but we're already there. Cash accounts for only about 4% of the total money in the system. The poor, those without bank accounts, rely heavily on cash, but this comes at a cost. Going fully digital removes the cash register, the ATM, and the cash transit vans. Cash is acceptable to vendors because its value is certain and, while counterfeit notes are known to exist, they are insufficiently plentiful to disrupt commerce. Enter the stablecoin. Gregor Kozel is the developer of the X8 stablecoin, one of several stablecoins offering currency stability by spreading assets over the 8 top currencies in the world as well as gold. Kozel is a former portfolio manager who spent several years developing a technique for portfolio risk management that did not rely on predicting whether asset prices would go up or down, but on measuring and limiting downside risk. He then translated his system to investments in banking, where treasury systems could be stress tested in milliseconds rather than the months it previously required. It was out of this experience that he developed the X8 stablecoin. Backed by AI, it is designed to fight inflation through artificially intelligent re-eating of the 8 underlying currencies and gold. As its name implies, the X8 stablecoin is not intended to shoot for the stars, as many investing in Bitcoin are hoping for. It is designed to hold its value, neither rising nor falling no matter what turbulence befalls the underlying currencies. Many companies attempt to replicate this by spreading their cash over multiple currencies, but this is both expensive and unwieldy. There are simply too many moving balls to do this efficiently. Each time someone invests in X8, new X8 coins are minted, and cash is transferred into the 8 underlying currencies and held at custodian banks. Once you are part of the stablecoin universe, you are able to make payments on the blockchain without using bank transfers. Global money decentralization. Many people say we are entering the age of AI, but we are already there, says Kozel. I don't see much future for fiat money 10 years from now. Fiat will probably still be in use, but I see the global monetary system being decentralized and taken out of the hands of central banks, which was the original vision of Bitcoin and blockchain. In a decentralized world, anyone will be able to mint their own currencies. Whether they will be accepted by others or not is another question. But there will be many different cryptocurrencies that will achieve broad acceptance. There are more than 5,000 cryptocurrencies, and a handful of these are stable coins. Tether was first to be launched and is a crypto coin that aims to be linked one-to-one with the US dollar. Then came True, US dollars coin, both linked to the US dollar, and Stasis Euro, backed by the Euro. Investing in this new world. Just as money is going through an evolutionary shift, so too is the world of investment. Advances in AI and quantum computing will connect us based on an intimate profile of each individual's investment risk tolerances and appetite, and furnish opportunities not presently available, says Kazell. AI will be able to track movements of capital and changes in competitiveness of economies around the world and adjust your stablecoin weightings at any given moment to provide money where it is needed, where it is most productive, so it is working for you. It will likewise revolutionize the world of investment by measuring in real-time opportunities to maximize returns and growth on a global basis. Where Bitcoin has got it wrong, it accused central banks of printing money, says Kazell. But central banks have a mandate to support their economies with whatever it takes. He adds, history shows us that if you are not adapting to the changing economic environment, you need new money to purchase new productivity growth, which includes innovations. If the same amount of currency is in circulation, people cannot buy the new things even if such innovations would change lives and businesses for the better. It blocks progress. Every time we went back to the gold standard, which happened a lot in history, it was abandoned. Is gold that bad? No, it only failed because you cannot adjust the volume of gold in synchronicity with the rate of innovative, real productivity growth to keep the economy and prices stable. Naturally, runaway money printing isn't good, yet fixed money supply is just as dangerous and both invariably lead to instability. Bitcoin has and will continue to have the same issue. It will have a fixed supply in the future. AI-driven stable coins are one way to overcome this problem. Hit the like and subscribe button to be alerted as more articles of interest are posted. Be sure to visit my Dinarian blog for all of today's articles of interest and find me on Facebook as I also post them on there as well. Pick up your free trial copy of the newly upgraded currency exchange planner before you leave. Use the promo code, thedinarian, to get 25% off at checkout when you decide to unleash the full planner's abilities, along with the mobile application added free for being my subscriber. This package will only be available for a limited time, so go for it, pick up yours today. With the currency exchange planner on your team, the banks don't have a chance of taking advantage of your newfound wealth. Register today as an affiliate with the Gold Savings Carrot Bar program. If you do not keep your savings in real asset like gold, you risk everything as the fiat system fails. Protect your family's wealth today in physical gold, as tomorrow may be too late. This program is made so even low-income people can buy gold, by offering it 1 gram at a time, which makes it affordable to everyone. Get involved today. It's free to register and secure your family's savings tomorrow. You can always turn gold back into any kind of fiat money you want or need later. The gold will always be in your possession, not the banks who do not care about your well-being. Above all, the gold will retain its purchasing power in good times as well as bad. The dollar, I assure you, will not. Did you know that the dollar only has 0.0389 cents purchasing power left when compared to its original purchasing power when the dollar first came out? Fiat currencies are based on debt, and are designed to fail over time. Ask yourself this. Why are all the central banks loading up on gold lately, and running from the current depreciating fiat US dollar? Do you think they do not know what is coming? Get yourself protected today, before it's too late. Both of the links to these invaluable programs are available in the description box below this video. Go check them out. Knowledge is power. Over and out, the Dinarian.